Part of Universal Design for Learning is creating course content that is easy to understand for a wide range of people, including those that may have a disability. Well-structured Microsoft Word documents with headings makes content easy to understand for everyone and works well with screen readers. This video tutorial demonstrates the basic skills for how to create well-structured Microsoft Word documents. Upon completion of this video tutorial, you should be able to understand the benefits of creating properly structured Microsoft Word documents for your course materials and be able to create a Microsoft Word document with proper heading structure to benefit all learners, including those that may be using assistive technologies such as a screen reader. All users can navigate quickly through the document, skim the content, and find information. It is especially easy to navigate when using the navigation pane, which I'll demonstrate shortly. Using Word's styles to create the headings results in a consistent appearance and is easy to maintain and revise. It is possible to take advantage of Word's automated and other convenient features, such as generating and maintaining a table of contents. There are other features too, such as creating a cross-reference, but that's beyond the scope of this tutorial. Bottom line, be aware that automated and convenient features are available when proper heading structure is used. A Word file can be exported as HTML or PDF files and retain the structure. HTML, hypertext markup language, is the most accessible type of online content as it does not require additional software to view and can be easily navigated by screen readers. PDF is Adobe's portable document format, widely used on the web and for course content. A document with proper heading structure interfaces well with assistive technologies such as screen readers. Headings are the only way a visually impaired student can navigate a document with a screen reader. Without headings, a student using a screen reader will need to listen to the entire document to find specific information. Proper structure is important for any document you create. To demonstrate how to create a document with proper structure in Microsoft Word, and take advantage of all these benefits, I'll use the syllabus template that is available on GRCC's site. The template can be downloaded by opening your browser and navigating to grcc.edu/syllabus. I've already downloaded and opened the syllabus template, as you can see here. This is the template that was approved by the Academic Governing Council. It contains the minimum requirements for all syllabi to be used by faculty. The instructor can add components and revise the formatting if desired. I'm using Word 2013 to view and edit this syllabus, but most of the features are similar in other more recent versions of Word, other word processing applications, and on a Mac or Windows. As I already mentioned, for students using assistive technologies such as screen readers, navigating a document is only possible when it has proper heading structure. This syllabus template already contains proper heading structure. For example, I'll position my insertion point within the title of the syllabus at the top of the page. The style for the title is a heading 1, as you can see in the Styles group on the Home tab. Now I'll position my insertion point in the General Information. The style for General Information is heading 2. Same for Section Policies when I scroll down, College Policies, and changes to the syllabus. All 4 of these are heading 2. I scroll back to the top of the syllabus and now I'm looking at the general information section again. Under the heading 2 sections, such as general information, there is a 3rd level headings. I'll position my insertion point where it says instructor name. Notice it says heading 3 in the styles group on the home tab. Same for contact information and availability. course information, student learning outcomes, and so on. The text that is not in bold is the normal style. No heading is applied. With my insertion point on normal style, for example, right here where it says name and title, notice in the styles group on the home tab, the normal style is selected. All of these headings and subheadings provide structure and it makes it easy to understand the content for everyone. A good way for you to see the document structure, get a quick overview of the heading styles used, and find any potential issues within your document structure is to turn on the navigation pane. And I'll go ahead and do that now. I'll click the View tab on my ribbon towards the upper right. And then I'll go ahead and check the box for navigation pane in the Show group. Unfortunately, the navigation pane is available only on PC. You won't see it on the Mac. With the navigation pane on, I can see the heading structure of my document very easily. It shows the entire outline. If I click the title at the top, Heading 1, I'll see the course name, number, and section syllabus. Click the next one down, the Heading 2, General Information, scrolls right down to that section of the document. Click Section Policies, scrolls right down to that section, and so on. I can click each of the headings to easily navigate to certain sections of the document. The navigation pane is an outline of your document, and it's based on the heading styles that you used. This makes it easy to see the structure and find problems where you may have missed applying a heading style. As you can see, navigating the document and skimming the contents is easy for everyone. This document will also export nicely into HTML, hypertext markup language, that is a web page, or a content area in Blackboard. And it will also export nicely as a PDF, Adobe's portable document format. Let's see how the structure of this document functions for someone using a screen reader. On the left side of the screen is the syllabus document with proper heading structure. You're looking at it in Microsoft Word. On the right side of the screen is a screen capture of how this document is navigated for a student using a screen reader, such as the well-known JAWS screen reader. A student can use shortcut keys to bring up a list of the headings as you see on the right, and then use arrow keys to navigate to the desired section. The JAWS heading list you see on the right is generated by the heading structure used in Word on the left. A screen reader works very similar to Word's navigation pane, except the keyboard is used in the screen reader to navigate the headings. Without this heading structure, it is not possible for a student using a screen reader to navigate the document. It can be very frustrating and cumbersome to find specific content in a long document without the ability to navigate it. We are now looking at the syllabus again in Microsoft Word. You can format content with different fonts, sizes, alignment, bold, color, etc., but it is easier and faster to achieve the same results using styles. Styles in Word or other similar programs not only control the appearance of the text, but the structure of the document as well. Structure is key for accessibility and to take advantage of all the other benefits I already mentioned at the beginning of this video. What I'll do next is customize this template for my course section. So I'll start at the top here with the heading 1, the title of my document. I'll select that, and I'll go ahead and type the name of my course here in the number. Next, I'll go down to the instructor name. This is the normal style, and it does not appear in the structure of the document. You will not see it in the navigation pane on the left. All text that is not bold in this syllabus template is the normal style. Notice the revised text for the heading does appear in the navigation pane of the document. Next, I'll add my contact information. Start here. And then I'll go ahead and just copy and paste the rest in here just to speed it up a bit. I'll add the course information directly from the CARP, which can be obtained from GRCC's website at grcc.edu/CARP. I switched to a browser. I typed in the grcc.edu/CARP. I'll now go to the site. And once I'm there, the first report that I want to click is right here for approved course curriculum documents. After I click the link for course approved curriculum documents, the next thing I want to do is type in my class number and click find or press the enter key. And on the results list, I can see my class. I'll go ahead and click the link for my class code. And under catalog description is the information that I want to copy and paste right into my syllabi. So I'll select all of the information for the course description, use Ctrl+C or Command+C on the Mac, and then switch back to the syllabus. And under course information, I'll highlight the existing text placeholder and then paste in the course information from the CARP. I'll use Ctrl+V or Command+V on the Mac. It looks like the bold was also brought in from when I copied it from the browser, so I'll select this paragraph and remove the bolding. I'll revise the rest of my syllabus later for the course. However, I would like to add another section to the syllabus now. Although this syllabus template contains the minimum requirements to be used by faculty, the instructor may add components if desired. To demonstrate how to add components with proper structure to the syllabus, I'll include a learning resources section to my syllabus. You may have something entirely different in mind that you wish to add to yours. To demonstrate how to add another section with proper structure, I'm going to go to the end of my syllabus and position my insertion point to the left of the word changes under changes to the syllabus. And then I'll press the enter key on my keyboard and then arrow up one. Notice in the navigation pane on the left and in the styles group on the home ribbon, I have a blank heading 2 in the document structure in which to add information. I'll type in learning resources. Because I had my insertion point positioned next to changes to the syllabus, a heading 2, when I press the enter key, Word automatically created another heading 2 in my document structure. Next, I'll add some information underneath learning resources. I'll press the enter key, I'll type in Blackboard, press enter again, and I'll type in this class uses. And to save time, instead of keep typing, I'm just going to paste the rest of the information in that I put on the clipboard. I'll include additional information, technical support, press enter, start typing the next paragraph. And again, I'll copy and paste already copied information to the clipboard, and I'll just paste it in here to save time. Blackboard and technical support should be a third level down in the structure of my document, as they're under learning resources. To make these two resources the third level down, I'll select each of them and apply the heading 3 style. Notice they're showing up as heading 3 and indented underneath learning resources in my navigation pane. That's why I say if you're using a PC, it is very nice to keep on the navigation pane so that you can see the structure of your document and that everything is showing as it should. I won't complete the entire document now, but hopefully you get the idea. Pay attention to the headings in the Styles group on the Home tab. These styles are what control the structure of the document, making it easier for all students to understand, including those using assistive technologies. For PC users, it is helpful to turn on the navigation pane. Remember, click View, look in the Show group, and check the box for navigation pane. The navigation pane is an outline of your document based on the heading styles you use. Not only is it a convenient way to navigate documents, but it also gives a good overall view of the content. Faculty should keep in mind proper heading structure for all documents, not just the syllabus. You're looking at the schedule document that I use for students, and I've used the same type of thinking to create this document. The title of my schedule has a heading 1, as you can see in the Styles group. Each week I gave a heading 2. And you can see how it's set up in the navigation pane on the left. For a student using a screen reader, this is very nice in that they can navigate right to the week for which they want to listen to. They don't have to listen to the entire schedule to find the specific week of interest. We're looking at the syllabus again now, but you may have noticed that the weekly schedule that I did just show you had shading on the headings. You can add shading, use different recommended fonts, color, size, etc. If you do not like the look of the headings and want to change the appearance, you can. There is a way to change the look of the headings and still retain the structure. I'll show you how to do that in the next video tutorial, Creating Well-Structured Microsoft Word Documents with Headings Part 2, which is for more advanced skills and also related to proper heading structure. To summarize, as you saw, all users can easily navigate and skim through a document with proper heading structure. We can easily see the structure in the navigation pane. The appearance in our syllabus is consistent. For example, all the heading 2 styles look the same. All the heading 3 styles look the same. It is easy to maintain and revise the styles used for the heading structure, which I'll show you how to do in the part 2 video. I did not create an automated table of contents, but you can by clicking the References tab and then the Table of Contents button. Word will do all the work for you to create and maintain a table of contents when you set up the proper heading structure. Word also has other automated and convenient features as well. So when you use heading structure that's set up properly, there are many features to help automate your work. When a document is set up with proper structure, it will export nicely as HTML, hypertext markup language, or PDF, portable document format, and retain its heading structure. Finally, as you saw in the JAWS screen capture, a document with proper heading structure interfaces well with assistive technologies. Without headings, a student using a screen reader will need to listen to the entire document, even if they only want to locate just one specific piece of information.